In this movie, we'll show the improvements of doors. Similarly to the windows, doors are now also organized in new folder structures. These reflect the operation type, shape, and functionality of the doors. To reduce the number of door library parts, many doors having the same or similar functionality were merged, and also in many cases improved. No previous functionality has been lost. Let's see an example. Select the sliding door library part and choose the opening type and length from the pop-up at the right. By clicking the opening type pop-up, we can choose the needed type of sliding door. In earlier versions, these types were separate library parts. New opening types are available for side light and transom sashes. For example, let's select the door with side light and transom door type and switch to the opening type and angle panel on the right. Here we can easily set the opening type of the side light and transom separately. Storefronts have been replaced and were given a dedicated folder in the library structure. They were updated to achieve the same functions as other doors. For example, nominal sizes and tolerance options were added, enabling the same dimensioning methods as other doors. Note: the same updates were performed on the storefront windows as well. The rolling shutter option of the openings has been improved. Let's see these details. Let's place a door or a window inside a wall, then select it and enter the settings dialog. On the basic window or door settings tab page, select the reveal settings from the pop-up, and let's choose the second reveal type here. Let's go to the casing settings and check both the inside and outside checkboxes to switch on the casings of the window. Finally, switch to the sunshade settings. From the type pop-up, let's select the rolling option to switch on the rolling shutter. Next to the on facade and behind facade, the two window placement option was added. All these options can now be used on the inside and outside casings on both sides of the frame. Let's select the two window option and then the arched shape box from the pop-ups. For rail position, let's choose the on wall and check the show casing behind sunshade checkbox. Finally, uncheck the 2D symbol to hide the shutter on the floor plan. Keep all other settings unchanged and click OK. Let's add a section through the window and see the result in the section window and then in the 3D window as well.